A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Great crowds were traveling with Jesus, and he turned and addressed them. If anyone comes to me without hating his father and mother, wife and children, brothers and sisters, and even his own life, he cannot be my disciple. Whoever does not carry his own cross and come after me cannot be my disciple. Which of you wishing to construct a tower does not first sit down and calculate the cost to see if there is enough for its completion? Otherwise, after laying the foundation and finding himself unable to finish the work, the onlookers should laugh at him and say, "This one began to build but did not have the resources to finish." Or what king marching into battle would not first sit down and decide whether with 10,000 troops he can successfully oppose another king advancing upon him with 20,000 troops? But if not, while he is still far away, he will send a delegation to ask for peace terms. In the same way, every one of you who does not renounce all his possessions cannot be my disciple. The Gospel of the Lord. Calculate the cost. Jesus' words in the Gospel appear rather shocking, turning one's back on father and mother, carrying one's cross. Undoubtedly, Jesus is saying hyperbole and overstatement to emphasize his point, his focused message. Nothing should ever turn us away from following Jesus. The number one in our lives is to be Jesus. Jesus then gives two parallel examples. The man building a tower must carefully calculate what it will cost him to finish the construction. Otherwise, he appears to be foolish to even begin the project. The king entering into a battle needs to assess his strength as well as the force of his opponent. When this is completed, he can decide his course of action. Jesus' followers must calculate the cost of discipleship, and the cost is high. Am I willing to carry my cross daily and following Jesus? Am I willing to surrender my inordinate material desires? Will I put following Jesus even above my various relationships? Lord, grant me your abundant grace to be your faithful disciple.